Hello everyone, welcome to EduTap and also welcome to the government scheme session. The scheme that we are covering today, it is formation and promotion of 10,000 FPO scheme, all right? So we are covering this particular scheme because see recently it was in news. So on 12th of July 2023, there was a national workshop on the form this particular scheme, that is promotion, formation and promotion of 10,000. So there is a target also that the government wants to achieve of farmers producer organization, all right? So whatever be the important dimensions that are related to this particular scheme, we are going to cover in today's session. But before that, here's an announcement for all the aspirants who are preparing for central regulatory bodies. We have come up with one-stop solution guide to all the queries that you must be having the organization you would want to join. For example, if you want to know about RBI, NABARD or SEBI, what's its role, how does it contribute to India's economy, what will be your role once you join the organization, right? Everything has been comprehensively covered. Once that is done, you would want to know about the recruitment process, right? So how many phases are there, what is the pattern of each phase, how many questions are asked, what is the previous year cutoff, and all other things, for example syllabus, for example cutoffs, trends, everything has been comprehensively covered so that you do not have any questions once you start off with the preparation. And you can download these e-guidebooks. I would say I would highlight that these are free of course, so you can download these from the link that is provided in the description box below. Now let's talk about the scheme, all right? First we will understand what is an FPO, then only we will understand what's the need of formation and promotion of it, right? So see, first of all, let's look at organization. So what is an organization? When many people, they come together and they form a group, that is known as an organization, all right? Who are the producers? Producers are who are producing something, right? For example, farmers, they produce crops. The people that are related to that are engaged in animal husbandry, right? Then we have fishermen also. We can include the weavers, the handicrafts, the people who are engaged in this sector also, because they are producing something, all right? So these producer organization, one thing I think you have understood that who comes under it, but what is it? So basically these producer organization are legal entities. What are legal entities? Means whatever these organizations are, these are either they either register themselves under the Company Act, okay, Company Act, or under the Cooperative Act of the particular state, okay? So what does it mean? Producer organization will always be a legal entity. It can be a company, it can be a cooperative society, right? But it must be registered in either under of those of a particular state, theek hai? Now in this particular scheme we are telling about the farmers, theek hai? To ye kiski organization, ye farmers ki producer organization. And now if you look at the name, the full form of the scheme, the full name, which is promotion, formation and promotion. So we have to form such FPOs. Now what is the need of that? See, if we look at in India, around 85% of farmers, they are small and marginal. Okay, small and marginal means they have small land and they do not have much money for the better equipments that can be utilized in the field, and because of which there will be higher return, right? They cannot give good inputs into the field, and because of that, because of the small land and of the other restrictions, the output that they have, that is also very little, right? And that little amount they sold either in the common place or whatever be the amount that is somebody is buying for them, they just sell it off, right? But we have to reduce that, right? That is why this concept has been formulated. And the best example of that could be Amul. So how that Amul company got started, because in Gujarat region, what happened, the people who were engaged with the milking, okay, so they used to sell their own. So every household had livestock, they used to sell the milk on their own to wherever place they used to sell, okay. Then Dr. Varghese Kurien, they pitched with this idea that instead of individually selling and getting minimal amount, it's better if all the milk from all the household that is collected and it is sold to a bigger company, right? So they would have better returns. And that is how this cooperative society, this all these things came into action, and Amul is now, we know how much it has reached today, right? So that is why with the same intention, these FPOs needs to be made, because so that these small farmers, first of all, on one hand, when they are collective, like they are cumulative, so if an FPO have one tractor, that can be utilized by all its members, right? Or whatever be the best inputs that can be bought, only one or two in quantity, and it can be utilized by everybody. Apart from that, they would also be taught about the marketing skills, other such capacity building will be done, some skills will be provided to them so that they can actually have good returns. ठीक है, तो उनका skill development भी होगा and they would be provided with some other facilities. Now what are these other facilities? For example, money will be provided so that storage infrastructure can be made, right? So now if there will be a common storage infrastructure, all the members they can utilize it, right? Similarly, if there is a truck, they have bought a truck together, so all that particular collectively whatever be the yield that has been generated, that can be sold off to the father places where they can get better return, right? So this is the concept and the need of forming the FPOs and then promoting it also, right? So government has decided that how much number should be there, right? So in adequate amount means adequately, they have said that in plains, if three this FPO group should be of at least 300 people, and if it is a northern eastern or hilly areas, including such other areas in UTs. What does it mean? Specifically has been mentioned northeastern areas and hilly areas. How? Because they have some restrictions where that is why they need more attention. ठीक है, because there are lesser people that live there, so 300 people will be a huge number for them, right? So that is why it has been said, sir, in UTs, if there are such certain areas which have this limitation of population, in that cases 100 will be the optimum number that will be considered. ठीक है, आई होप दिस कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ एफपीओ इज क्लियर. नाउ लेट्स अंडरस्टैंड द बेसिक्स एंड देन वी विल अंडरस्टैंड द ऑब्जेक्टिव. यू हैव ऑलरेडी अंडरस्टूड. देन वी विल लुक एट द फाइनेंशियल असिस्टेंस विच इज अ इंपॉर्टेंट कॉम्पोनेंट ऑफ द स्कीम. ठीक है, लॉन्च ईयर ऑफ द स्कीम इज 2020. सो फेब्रवरी 2020 द स्कीम वॉज लॉन्च फ्रॉम चित्रकूट उत्तर Pradesh, and it falls under the Ministry of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare. Aim we have already understood, that is to provide supportive ecosystem. Okay, we have to provide such ecosystem to form new FPOs, and the target we already know. The target is to produce 10,000 FPOs in 5 years. So this was scheme was launched in 2020, and 2024 tak it's being expected. So that would be the 5 years time duration where it is expected to form 10,000 FPOs. ठीक है. What is the type of scheme? See, what does it mean? So these people, I said that they will be trained, right? And initially, because see, all are small and marginal farmers, so of course, even if they want to have a storage facility, a tractor or any such thing, they do not have money, right? That is why initially some support will also be provided by the government, financial support, and this financial support will be borne by the central government, and that is why it is a center sector scheme. State will play its role. State will help to form the FPOs, to train them and all other things, but the financial funding under this scheme will be done by the central government only. ठीक है, objectives you have already understood. Now it's just a formality that we have to do, right? So we have to government will aim to provide holistic and broad based supportive ecosystem. Means broad based means a very like hand holding will be at wider level, right? At wider aspects. ठीक है, for the new FPOs that will be formed. ठीक है, एम क्या है, ऑब्जेक्टिव क्या है, प्रोडक्टिविटी इंक्रीज करना. ठीक है, एफिशिएंट बनाना उनको, उनको कैपेसिटी बिल्डिंग करना. ठीक है, कॉस्ट इफेक्टिव और सस्टेनेबल रिसोर्सेज का यूज, हाउ दे कैन एक्चुअली यूटिलाइज, दे कैन हैव सस्टेनेबल रिसोर्स यूज. ठीक है, अपना जो भी उनका प्रोडक्शन है उसको कैसे कॉस्ट इफेक्टिव बना सकते हैं, हाउ टू यूज मिनिमल अमाउंट इन द फील्ड एंड गेट मैक्सिमम आउटपुट. सो बेसिकली दिस टॉक्स अबाउट इंक्रीजिंग देयर प्रोडक्टिविटी बाय प्रोवाइडिंग देम विद सम स्किल्स. ठीक है, नॉट ओनली दैट दैट दीज एफपीओज विल ऑल्सो बी told about or they will be taught about how they can get higher returns through the better market linkage. So market linkage may be help karenge. This is what this broad based supportive ecosystem means. Along with that, they would also be taught how to actually engage in the market. Theek hai, hand holding and support, again the same thing, up to 5 years we have looked at for from year of creation. For example, if some FPO, although the scheme was launched in 2020, but any FPO was formed in 2022, so from 2022 till 5 years this particular hand holding will be done. ठीक है, and capacity building also. So if you read it, this is the same thing only which we have already discussed. ठीक है, now if you look at the total budget, so this total budget that has been allocated for this scheme is, when the scheme was launched back in 2020, it was 6865 crore. Okay, but furthermore this particular budget was divided into two phases, right? So means concept will remain the same, but this budget allocation will have different objective at different phase. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, फ्रॉम द ईयर 2019 से 2023-24 तक, जब तक ये 5 ईयर्स का टाइम पीरियड है, द अमाउंट दैट विल बी गिवन विल बी 4496 करोड़. ओके, देन फॉर द नेक्स्ट 4 ईयर्स, ठीक है, फॉर द नेक्स्ट 5 ईयर्स, आई एम सॉरी, ठीक है, देन वॉट विल बी डन, 2369 करोड़ दैट विल बी प्रोवाइडेड for the financial support. What does it mean? It means again the same thing. For example, if somebody has taken loan in 2022, okay, then it is 23, then 24, then 25, then 26, right? So till 2026, the hand holding has to be done, right? And this scheme is valid till 2024 only, right? So means till 2024, the target will be to have 10,000 FPOs, but we know the condition under the scheme, that is to help handhold the FPOs for 5 years, right? So if some particular FPO अगर वो कभी बाद में बना है, 23, अगर मान लो 22 में बना है, तो उसका 5 years कब कंप्लीट होगा? इट्स 5 years विल बी कंप्लीटेड in 26, 26, right? So at that time only, also that for that time they also require money, है ना? That is why this distribution of money, which is overall 6865, it will be provided in two phases. In first phase, till the 5 year duration, and after that also, because the FPOs that have been formed and in accordance to when they will reach to 5 years, they need some financial support, right? So that is why it will be provided. ठीक है? Some other key features, let's look at it. So there will be cluster-based business organization that will provide training. So we are saying कि training provide होगी, है ना? So that will be the training will be provided for the 5 years duration that we already know. And here, the Department of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare will allocate the states to the implementing agencies. What does it mean? Basically, देखो, under this scheme, a lot of stakeholders are there. State is there, NABARD is there. There will be various implementing agencies. ठीक है, तो basically क्या होगा कि main जो head देखेगा, because we know it falls under the Minister of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare. They only will take care of everything. In this particular statement, you just have to remember कि cluster based business organization बनेंगी, जो कि initial training provide करेंगी. ठीक है? Then at least 15% FPOs would be from aspirational districts. What are aspirational districts? These are those district in a particular state which are not as developed as the rest of the state. Or in other language, if I say they were ignored for a while now, and other states were more have become more developed, and now focus needs to be given on those states. Sorry, those districts, so that they can be level they can be in the same level of the other districts. ठीक है, तो इसमें expected है under the scheme. तो हमारे government ने क्या करा है, in every state they have come up with some aspirational districts. ठीक है, so under the FPO, where these farmers producer organization will be formed by the government, trained by the government, and financial assistance will be given by the government. It is aimed that 15% of these FPO should be from the aspirational districts. ठीक है, and one FPO in each block. ठीक है, ऐसा ना हो कि एक ब्लॉक में वी हैव 10 to 15 FPOs एंड देन इन अदर ब्लॉक्स वी डोंट हैव एनी, राइट? सो दिस इज ऑल्सो वन एम. एंड देन फार्मर्स प्रोड्यूसर ऑर्गेनाइजेशन विल बी प्रमोटेड अंडर वन डिस्ट्रिक्ट वन प्रोडक्ट क्लस्टर. वॉट डज इट मीन? बेसिकली सी, आई हैव गिवन दिस एग्जाम्पल मल्टीपल टाइम, आई गिव दैट अगेन. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, आगरा का पेठा, इट इज़ वेरी फेमस, राइट? सो इफ यू गिवन एन ऑप्शन टू हैव नॉर्मल पेठा एंड वन फ्रॉम आगरा का पेठा, यू वुड वॉन्ट टू ट्राई इट, बिकॉज इट हैज़ इट्स ओरिजिनलिटी, यू कैन से, और इट इज़ फेमस फॉर इट, राइट? सिमिलरली अंडर फार्मर्स प्रोड्यूसर ऑर्गेनाइजेशन ऑल्सो इट विल बी प्रमोटेड दैट वट एवर बी दैट डिस्ट्रिक्ट, it should you know, it gives one thing only, so that it becomes famous, and this will help in specialization. So whatever they are specialized at, they would be selling that for better processing, marketing, branding, and export. ठीक है, देखो, FPOs, in FPOs, one more thing I want to clarify, it just not talks about growing something and selling something, right? If they all are together, if 300 farmers are together, their land are together, they can have some other source of income as well. For example, they all can go for beekeeping, right? They all can cumulatively go for mushroom cultivation. They all can cumulatively go for seed production. So basically, what happens? See, for seed product, when seeds, we say, no, quality seeds should be used. So how these quality seeds are made? They are first grown themselves, right? So there are various restrictions that are associated with it. For example, see, if a plant, it is growing in a particular land, right? So it has pollination, means the I hope you all know what is pollination, right? Male reproductive organ, they with the help of pollen, which is yellow in color, you must have observed in flowers, okay? They fertilize the female part. ठीक है, now if in an open field, we want quality seeds, right? But it's an open field, it can be fertilized from every from the nearby place, right? So that is why if whole village it is growing just one thing, there are lesser chances of impurity, right? What does it mean? For example, देखो, I want to grow quality seeds for cauliflower. So this is my field, but these are the rest of the fields of other farmers, and they are also growing cauliflower. Why? Because this is the particular season, right? But I am growing that for seed, okay? But they are growing for the bud which they can sell it, ठीक है? And mine should not be an impurity because I want to grow quality seeds, right? But because of the nearby farm, the land that they have and the cauliflowers that are grown there, fertilization can happen, impurity can happen. But if whole village, if all these farmers are growing for seed only and they are growing the same variety so that they can have the same result, now the chances of this pollination, it is very reduced, right? Because if whole village is doing that and rest apart, there is no other place from where these pollens can come. So, of course, the chances of purity is much high. Okay? So, what does it mean? FPOs. Here we talked about one district, one product. No, it's just not limited to the conventional farming, but it is much more utilization that can be done. Okay? आई होप दिस इज क्लियर. नाउ लेट्स टॉक अबाउट फाइनेंशियल असिस्टेंस. कुछ डेटा है जो आपको याद करना पड़ेगा, ठीक है? हेयर फाइनेंशियल असिस्टेंस टू ईच एफपीओ, वी आर सेइंग नो 5 years हैंड होल्डिंग विल बी डन अलॉन्ग विद कैपेसिटी बिल्डिंग. सम मनी इज रिक्वायर्ड फॉर मेकिंग, फॉर देम टू हैव इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर, फॉर देम टू हैव ट्रांसपोर्टेशन, फॉर देम टू हैव न्यू इक्विपमेंट्स, राइट, विच कैन बी यूटिलाइज. सो इनिशियली हैंड होल्डिंग विल बी डन, फाइनेंशियल असिस्टेंट टू एफपीओ विल बी 33 लाख, बट इज अ डिविजन इन इट, ठीक है? हेयर what are the other things, let's look at it, ठीक है? 18 लाख आपका पर एफपीओ विल बी गिवन फॉर 3 years, ठीक है? इनिशियली इसमें मतलब कोई कंडीशन नहीं है, इट विल बी गिवन, दे कैन बी यूटिलाइज एनी हाउ, राइट? अपार्ट फ्रॉम दैट, see these FPO farmers, they are making their organization. Of course, they would also want to grow much faster, so they would also contribute some amount to their own FPOs, right? So here government, they will even have equity grant. Equity grant means equal grant, okay? Equal grant, whatever be the means per farmer, per farmer member in an FPO, the government will give ₹2,000, ठीक है? मैक्सिमम लिमिट कितनी होगी? 15 लाख की. बिकॉज से इफ इन इन एन एफ पी ओ इफ देर आर मोर पीपल दैट आर देयर, सो द अमाउंट विल बी मोर, बिकॉज 2,000 पर फार्मर के हिसाब से देखेंगे तो अमाउंट काफ़ी ज़्यादा हो जाएगा, राइट? दैट इज़ वाई कितना है, 15 लाख की मैक्सिमम लिमिट रखी, अपर लिमिट फॉर द एफ पी ओ, बट इक्विटी ग्रांट फॉर एफ पी ओ 2,000 पर फार्मर मेंबर. वॉट डज इट मीन? इक्वल अमाउंट ऑफ ₹2,000 पर फार्मर विल बी प्रोवाइडेड, ठीक है? देन क्रेडिट गारंटी, दिस amount which we are saying earlier, it is the financial assistant help that is there, but if the FPO want to take any loan also, that facility is also there. So credit guarantee means what? It means that FPO, when they are going for project loans, okay, credit guarantee means guarantee, here the government will provide guarantee on behalf of FPOs, okay? And this guarantee will be given to how much? Up to ₹2 crore. See, whenever FPO will go to loan, they won't go to government, they would go to bank, right? And on what basis bank should trust them, right? So government is providing trust. And to how much extent they are providing trust? They are providing up to 2 crore rupees. Okay? Financial assistance of 25 lakh is provided to CBBO only, also because they will train the FPOs, right? So they also require money for administration, for going to the villages to train them and all these things. So 25 lakh per FPO is provided to CBBO as well. Okay? Ab isme agar koi existing FPOs hain, they are allowed to avail the relevant benefits. Agar unhone pehli aisi koi similar schemes agar nahi है, they can take benefit under this particular scheme, ठीक है? So in the previous slide we talked about the guarantee will be given by the government, ठीक है? So it's not like that government are verbally going to say to the bank that okay, we will provide loan up to you can provide loan up to 2 crore, if they're not able to pay we will back you, we will back them, right? It cannot be verbally done, so there is a trust that needs to be made, right? So for that a fund has been made, okay? This fund of 1,500 crore has been made, ठीक है? Now this 1,500 crore is divided, this amount has been divided, जो भी अब हम आगे देखेंगे, ठीक है? So in 2 sections, ठीक है? पहली बात तो जो नाबार्ड की जो सब्सिडरी है संरक्षा, I'm sorry, ठीक है? तो देखो नाबार्ड है, उसकी 6 subsidiaries है, ठीक है? तो उसमें से एक आप कौन सी है? संरक्षा, ठीक है? तो उसमें कितना अमाउंट होगा आपका? अप टू 1 crore तक, 1,000 crore तक का उसमें होगा. एंड दिस सिमिलर कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन हैज टू बी डन बाय दिस इक्वल, देयर शुड बी इक्वल कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ द डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर एंड फार्मर्स वेलफेयर नाबार्ड. देखो इनिशियली हमने क्या समझा दैट दिस स्कीम विल बी इम्प्लीमेंटेड बाय वेरियस स्टेक होल्डर्स दैट वी हैव अंडरस्टूड राइट. सो हियर दिस गारंटी फंड ऑफ कोर्स इट विल बी मेड इन नाबार्ड ओनली बिकॉज नाबार्ड ओनली प्रोवाइड इट इज द एपेक्स बॉडी फॉर एग्रीकल्चर ऑल द एक्टिविटीज दैट गोज ऑन इन एग्रीकल्चर इन इंडिया मीन्स इन टर्म्स ऑफ बैंक राइट. अपेक्स बॉडी तो आपकी ICAR है, आई होप यू वॉन्ट गेट कन्फ्यूज. ठीक है, तो नाबार्ड में जो नब संरक्षा है उसमें तो आपका फंड खुलेगा. ठीक है, इसमें आपका क्या होगा, 1,000 करोड़ विल बी सबमिटेड. ऑफ दिस 1,500 करोड़ 1,000 करोड़ विल बी बाय अंडर नब संरक्षा. ठीक है, बाकी आपका नेशनल कोऑपरेटिव डेवलपमेंट कॉर्पोरेशन में बाकी कितना होगा, 500 करोड़ होगा. और ये 500 करोड़ जो होगा इक्वल कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर फार्मर्स वेलफेयर एंड आपका जो NCDC है इसका होगा इक्वल कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन मीन्स हाफ ऑफ विल बी देयर. So that was the news. I hope now you'll be able to understand about why, and in fact now you can understand national workshop it is done because we have to promote right this particular scheme right. So there's a homework for you all. I hope you have understood the scheme. If you have any questions you can always ask me. These are the toppers of the last session. Only one was the correct answer, and Yadu Lal, I'm sorry it's harder to pronounce name because now username are there, but Lal has given the right answer. We have Rings saying the right answer. Then thank you Akhil, and see Basie, I'm sorry, it cannot be pronounced. I hope you can understand that. See, we will definitely come up with marathon sessions for exclusively for NABARD. If you're talking about RBI, I'm sorry, your questions, it is not clear. If you're talking about RBI, we have already come up with the marathon sessions. You can watch it. If you're specifically talking for NABARD, when the examination will be near, we will definitely come up with marathon schemes. Okay, so please look at it, which examination you're talking about. We already have covered that. If it is RBI, then yes. So horrified. Yes, for 2023, we will definitely come up with the sessions. But let the notification come first, and the examination should be there. Because what we have understood, your 3 to 4 months are most important before the examination. 3 to 4 months are most important. So once we get to know that, then only we will come. We'll be able to do that. Okay, Akhil. I hope your query is resolved. Okay. Thank you everybody for watching the session. If you have any query, any doubt, please write to us. I'll definitely reply either in the comment section or in the next video. And if you like the session, please subscribe to our channel, and you can also join our Telegram channel to get the PDF of this and every lecture that we provide here on YouTube. So if you suggestions are always welcome. So if you want me to cover any scheme, please let me know as that as well, and we'll meet again with another video. Until then, all the very best for examination, and thank you.